Yeah, welcome back to my latest video and greetings from my club from Cologne. The content of this video is the new configuration menu, or in short words, config menu, which comes up with the latest update called Delta Videos. The configuration menu gives you the possibility to adapt the machines as your personal needs. To make those configurations, you need a medium which has studio rights, so administration and an active training plan. So very important, studio rights and an active training plan are required. Then you normally log on to your machines. You open the Milon setup, and when you go down, you will see another menu which is also called setup. And then on the right side of the screen, there's a submenu popping up. So we go through from left to right. First of all, update. With the submenu update, you might check if you have the latest update on your machine. In this case, it is Delta Videos. And if you would like to have some further information about the content of the update, you might scan the QR code. Next one is the display. First, you might choose your background color out of those 5 colors. Then you can activate or deactivate the screensaver. The screensaver is the circuit, the Milon disk, running around the display when nobody is training. And you can also choose when it should be activated. And you can turn on and off the auto brightness in order to save some energy. If turned off, you can make your changes manually. If turned on, the display will adapt to the room light in your training room. Next one, the mode. The first part of the mode I already presented in another video, how to switch between Q3 and Q circuit mode. Just press on either of it and all machines within one group, within one circuit, will be changed into free or circuit. But new is the timetable, which is called Q planner. With this timetable, you may pre-program the machines. That means you can pre-program when the machines should be in circuit mode, when it should be in Q3 mode, or when it should be in standby mode. When you press save, all the settings will be taken over. And last but not least, the training modes. First of all, the general settings. Over here, you can turn on and off the countdown in the beginning of the power test. You can activate and deactivate the rating dialog at the end of a training set. And when activated, you may now do automatic adjustments in terms of the training weights. Therefore, you just click on the edit button over here, and then a list pops up showing all the machines you have in your club. And now you can define for every machine separately what should happen when the client has done his rating. So it is possible to have an automatic increase or decrease of the training load according to the subjective feeling of the members. And over here, the training summary. When the training summary is activated, you get an result, or your training results will be shown at the end of a training set. The next one is just for Q3. Therefore, obviously, the switch mode must be activated and all machines must be in Q3 mode. Then you have the possibility to make all changes you have done on one machine to be taken over to all machines which are in Q3 mode as well. And what should happen at the end of a training set? Will you be remained logged in to do another set, or will you be automatically logged out? When you have done all your changes, you just press on the triangle over here. Then everything will be saved and the machine jumps back into your training mode. Yeah, that's it so far with a short explanation of the config menu. I personally really like the features and the gimmicks. Pretty cool, in my opinion. As always, I wish you all the best. I wish you fun with the gimmicks, with the features, and if you have any kind of questions, please do not hesitate to get back to us.